So devices are in Intune. We have enabled a couple of them. They have enrolled them into Intune. Here we can see that it's not just, obviously not just Windows. One of the things that has happened lately is that if you check out the devices view, in my case, you have like an all new kind of view. If you would compare this to what we see in the lab, if I check overview here, we have a couple of devices, and here we have this line here. It says, do you want to show the next version of what Intune looks like? If I select this, I can enable the preview view, and that will indeed change me to that, to the new view. To be honest, I like that new view better, so I'm going to keep it. So this is my list of devices. The devices are here. As you can see, in my case, I have devices by my family members. As you can see, some of them are personal, some of them are corporate. I try to locate my girlfriend's computer by doing locate device. Now, this is a time-consuming process. As you can see, locate device is pending, so we'll just have to be patient for that. But if I would select a device here, for example, my son's computer, and if I would check his device, which is personal, so if I want to go in and say, hey, I want to locate that device, you can see that the function here is grayed out because it's a privacy-related thing. So yeah, that is something that we want to understand at this point. You can, however, change that value. So for example, if I go into my Windows 11 ARM virtual machine, which I use for my whiteboards, you can see in this case the ownership is corporate. If I want to change this, I can go into properties, then I can device ownership switch to personal, and then down here I have to sort of acknowledge that I know what I'm doing and then click save. And now I have switched the device ownership from corporate to personal. It has everything to do with the privacy-related settings. Yes. No, if you register manually, like we did in our example, it will always be personal. If you have automated your registration, for example, via a group policy and a hybrid AD join, then it will be set to corporate. Now, you can change this, and I would like to change everything to personal, as long as it's personal, of course. If we do not have a, if it's a corporate device, well, we might not even have a primary user here, right? Sometimes you don't need a primary user because sometimes we have a kiosk PC. There's no dedicated user for that kiosk PC, so we don't want that. So here we have devices in Intune. Now, if you look at what we can do when a device is in Intune, then for example, I can select one of the devices here. Then you'll see a couple of options here in the top. Retire, again, this will put the device, it will remove the device from Intune. It will remove all corporate data from the device, but personal data will be kept. Wiping the device is a factory reset. You can also wipe the device, but still keep the enrollment state and the associated user, which means that the device will remain in Intune. Typically, you can just wipe. That will be a full factory reset. If you want to the if you think that the device is lost and you will never see it connect to the internet again, you can click delete. Because retire the device or wipe the device will make Intune wait for the client to do something and to report back that it did indeed do that something. If we know that the device is never going to touch the internet again, for example, we went on a moon mission and we just forgot about it there. Hey, that may happen. Or let's say you were on a boat and accidentally the device fell overboard into the bottom of the ocean It will probably never connect to the internet again. Unless SpongeBob may find it and try to sign in, but I guess not. Then wipe the device. It will just be deleted from the database and we'll just forget about it. Other things sometimes are grayed out, but that is because of the operating system. For example, remote lock and reset passcode here are two options that I can use, but not for Windows. I have also, for example, my iPad here. And my iPad allows me to remote lock or reset the password, right? So here we see for an iPad, we see different options. Then we have restart functionality. If I want to piss my girlfriend off, I would now click restart and it will restart the computer. Other things, a fresh start will remove preloaded Win32 apps. Autopilot reset is something you can only get if the device was initially enrolled into Intune via autopilot. For example, my girlfriend's computer was enrolled via autopilot. My daughter's computer wasn't. Oh, it was, apparently. Let's check out my son's computer then. Ah, my son's computer wasn't, and therefore you can see autopilot reset is not available. We have quick scan for anti-malware, full scan for anti-malware. Other things like update Windows Defender Security Intelligence, depending a little bit on the situation, because in this case, it's a personal device. Therefore, I cannot rename it. I cannot do BitLocker key rotation, no location. That is all disabled. If a device is corporate, we could do these things. And one that is quite important is that we can click sync. And this will force that client to get the latest Intune policy updates. From the client perspective, you could also do something like this. So let's say here we have that client and where is my mouse? Oh, here it is. So let's go into settings, go into accounts, access worker school. Then we'll see here that my device is indeed connected to EntraID. And here we can see the managed by. This is the Intune line. And then if I click info, here we can see, for example, everything that we are receiving from Intune, like device installation things, BitLocker, browser settings, device lock settings, something with Edge, something with the smart screen, something with power settings, some applications. And here in the connection info, we can see something like this, r.manage.microsoft.com. Anything that is manage.microsoft.com is always in tune. So that's always in tune. And here we also have a sync button. And we can go say, hey, I want you to now go to Intune, get the latest policy updates. Now, if you don't do this at all, it will happen every 8 hours or so. We'll just, you know, every so many hours, we go and check if there's new things happening. But if you manually want to sort of give it a push, either from that control panel or from the settings app or from the portal, you can do this. One other thing is that what you might like also is on a client, you can also deploy an app called the Company Portal app. The Company Portal app is an client-side application that users can use to communicate with Intune. So for example, if I make software available for users, then here we can, for example, see the applications that I have made available. I, for example, have made available the Microsoft Emulator, Microsoft Power Toys, and Microsoft Loop. Have you ever worked with Microsoft Loop? Microsoft Loop, you can find at loop.microsoft.com is where you can stay in the loop. So if you sign in into Microsoft Loop, it is, I hear things about Microsoft Loop, that this is going to be sort of the next generation of OneNote. So you can get rid of OneNote, but start using Loop, and it's all used to sort of be closer to your coworkers, where you can more easily work together. So apparently, I forgot about it, but apparently I have deployed Microsoft Loop to my organization, and I can find information about that, for example, in that company portal. Here, in the company portal client app, we can also go into devices. We can then see that this is the device that I am using at this point. We can actually open that up. And now we can, for example, also go in actions. And we may want to go and rename the device here. As a user, we can do this ourselves. We can reset the device from here, maybe reset the pin for the device. Other things that we, so this is something that we could do from here, managing the device. If a user has multiple devices here, I can also go and take one of the other devices that I own and also, for example, reset that other device. So if I would click this button, within a few seconds, I will get a phone call because my girlfriend will then call me and say, hey, why is my computer going into a factory reset? Let's not try that. These kind of things, this is what we can do if we check out the if you check out that company portal app. So devices are now in Intune. Now, because a device is in Intune, automatically all kinds of things are going to happen on that client. One of the things that will happen on a client is that it's going to run an inventory. So if you open up one of the items, one of the devices in Intune, and you can then go into monitor and click hardware, you will see a little bit of information about the hardware. Not too much, just a little bit of information. Nothing compared to Config Manager. Discovered applications is a certain level of, this is a certain level of software-based inventory. Google Earth, Microsoft Teams is here, Acrobat stuff, some Office stuff. You can see all kinds of applications being installed here. This is the first bits, let's say, right? So the device is now in Intune. We have in our lab environment, we have a couple of devices in Intune. So we should be able to see at least a little bit of information on those devices there. It might take a little while before everything is populated properly, but well, at least we have something that we can get started with. Then, if we move forward, there is a couple of things that we might want to go and set up for our environment. Now in Intune, if you check out the Intune portal here on the left hand side, because you have devices here, you may be using some extra things. One of the things that I like to check out is, it's not super hidden, but it's quite nice, especially if you use Microsoft Surface devices. You can go into the All Services view here. And here we have a Surface Management portal, and this allows us to go and check out which devices in my organization are Microsoft Surface devices. And we can get information about, for example, a warranty. In my case, all of them are expired. So we can actually see which of my devices have expired warranties here. But from here, we might want to create support requests, or we might need a repair request if we have a broken device. Some extra tools about how to, well, work with Surface devices. Or check how much carbon emissions we have saved because we are using Microsoft products. Yeah, that's super important, but I'm not sure if that is something that we want to see at this point. as you can see, I have saved enough to have a vehicle travel for 1.22 kilometers. See, I'm doing a good thing. It's not part of Intune. It's just like a separate component, but Microsoft chose to put the portal of that separate surface management component in the Intune portal. Yeah, so that's basically what it is. I try to put it in as one of my favorites, and it shows here, but the next time it will be gone for some reason. So another location in the portal that is important is the tenant administration component. Now here in the tenant administration bits, you get all kinds of components that are related to how Intune works itself, the background product. So if you want to make some fundamental changes to Intune, you need to be in the tenant administration. All the other things here in the Intune portal is just about the use of Intune. One of the things that I regularly check when working with Intune is that tenant status view, and I check the service release. In my case, I am running service release 2401. And if you open that up, what you'll be accessing is a blog about what is new in Microsoft Intune. And what you'll notice if you read this, you'll notice that Intune is one of those products that is typically changed about every week. Microsoft changes things in Intune every single week. Sometimes they skip a beat, but not often. For example, here, if you check out the list of dates, and I'd show all the 26 dates, you can go back, you can see that typically every week we see changes in Intune. Every time when a date is mentioned, we have seen new features or changes to features. So here we have Intune Enterprise Application Management stuff. Advanced analytics are here. We can see in the week of January 22nd, we can see that there was a new service release, which is a big update. So we can see, hey, what can we now do? Change, what is change? Enter the user app pin reset, I don't know. What about Android devices? A date and time picker for managed software updates, device management capabilities, BlackBerry Protect Mobile Now supports app protection policies. All right. Device security, Intune applications that we can add, all kinds of updates. And then 1 week earlier, or like 2 weeks earlier, we have this. Okay, we had a new release here as well. And we can see all the different changes happening all of the time. So what I do typically is every other week, I'll check it out, see if there's something big, something that I want to know about. If you work on Intune on a daily basis, you might be seeing things that you never seen before. It happens to me all the time. So I'm teaching Intune this week, and I am pretty sure that I will be see new buttons when we go along the course. So this is one of the basics. Down here in the connectors and tokens, you can see that we can configure all kinds of connectors to all kinds of locations. For example, if you are using Jamf for managing macOS devices, you might want to go into partner device management here. And this is where you can just go and say, hey, I'm going to go and connect Jamf in Intune. And then what we get is we can get information from Jamf in Intune, for example. Or for example, if you have like a mobile threat defense solution, you can go in and say, hey, we have, let's say we are using Zimperium or Pradeo or Wandera, I don't know. If you have any these kind of solutions in place, you might want to go and connect it into Intune to exchange information. Partner compliance management for different operating systems. We have different kinds of partners that we can also go in and integrate into Intune. So if Intune needs more, then, well, there is kind of, there's a couple of different solutions that we can integrate. For example, ServiceNow connectors. If you're a ServiceNow customer, which is like a ticketing system, you can connect your ServiceNow connection. Or if you have TeamViewer licenses, you can connect Intune to TeamViewer, and you can then start using TeamViewer to take control of remote systems. So just like that, we do have quite a few things that we can do from the tenant environment. Now, typically, these are not things that you will be doing every week. You know, you will set up a couple of things and you will do that like once in the beginning of your Intune environment, and that's basically it. One setting that you might like to think of is a setting that is called multi-admin approval. Now, multi-admin approval, when set up right, you can then go in and see, hey, we see something in my, or someone in my organization wants to make a change in Intune, and then someone else has to sort of go and say, yes, that's all right. So like this is the, according to the zero trust principle, we can implement the principles of four eyes, right? We have at least two people working on a change, except for, instead of just one breaking everything. Huh? So this is a feature that is relatively new. And another thing that you might want to check out is the Intune add-ons. Here in Intune add-ons, what we'll see is that this is where you can start thinking about other licenses than Intune Plan 1. Intune Plan 1 is the default Intune license. This is the license that you get if you are licensed with Microsoft 365 E3, E5, A3, A5, and Business Premium. But in some cases, you will need extra solutions. One of them, for example, is Remote Help, which allows administrators or support desk engineers to take over user screens, and those users in that support desk, they would need a Remote Help license. Enterprise Application Management allows IT admins to easily discover prepackaged applications, deploy them, and keep them updating. This is like working with a new kind of store. Advanced Analytics allows you to do more monitoring on your clients. Endpoint Privilege Management allows standard users, so non-admins, to run specific applications in admin mode. And Intune Plan 2 is offering, for example, support for special devices like Teams meeting rooms or augmented reality, virtual reality devices, firmware over the air for Android systems that they need to get a new firmware via the internet, or tunnel mode for mobile applications. So we can, for example, force mobile applications on Android or iOS devices to go and use a VPN tunnel before they do anything. But these are special things that we need to license separately. If you want to get the most out of Intune, you want to give some people at least the Microsoft Intune Suite license, because that contains everything. So what you might want to do is you might want to make sure that your administrators or support desk engineers get a little bit extra over Intune Premium Plan or Intune Plan 1. For the rest of your users, the bulk of all the users you have, Intune Plan 1 is just fine. Because with Intune Plan 1, you can deploy configurations, you can deploy software and updates, you can deploy compliance monitoring, you can monitor the devices in a basic way, just fine. In my organization, I think I have, in my organization, I have, I have, let's see, Alex at alexjung.com. I think, what do we want? Oh, I think I have purchased the Intune suite. I'm pretty sure about that. But that's, and that gives us different capabilities, right? So what kind of capabilities did we activate in my organization? So you can actually check this out. To be honest, I would really like Microsoft to release anytime soon Microsoft 365 E7, because, and then give me everything again. Because for some reason, Microsoft, you know, they now have E5, but if you have E5, you do not have Intune Suite. You have to still purchase this separately. Or if you have E5, you do not have Teams Premium. That's a separate purchase. Or you do not have Microsoft 365 Copilot. It's a separate purchase. Just let me pay $100 per month. I don't care. As long as I get everything. That's just, you know, I want everything because I need it because I have to show you guys about that stuff, right? So for me, E7 would be nice. Apparently, Microsoft is not thinking about that yet. So I'll just have to be a little bit patient here. Another thing, maybe you want to customize the end user experience for Intune. So in one of the labs, we did customize the Azure Active Directory end user experience, right? We can change the way Entra ID looks for the user, but we can also do that for Intune. We can go into settings and we may want to go and change the logo. Maybe want to go and change the color that we are using. So, for example, here, if I go into that portal.manage.microsoft.com, which is the Intune web portal for a user. If I want to change the color here from blue to, let's say, orange, like this, let's click save. And I would go in here and then sort of refresh. You can see that my color is changed to orange. Yeah? No worries. So when it comes to some basics of Intune, let's say some basic settings that you can do in Intune, for example, change the notifications, change the color a little bit. So I'm going to go back to blue here. We can upload our own logos to make it look better. You can add your own support information, which users will find in the company portal app. We can do some settings with enrollment, privacy URLs, custom management, custom messages that you want to go into. All of these things we can customize in the user experience customization settings. Other things we can do is, for example, push organizational messages, where you can go and say, hey, you know what? I want to push a message to all my users that they have to restart their computer because we did a certain update. So here we can push organizational messages. Here you can send messages with your organization's logo directly to their users, to their Windows 11 devices. So just like this, we can go and start pushing something. So maybe I want to show a taskbar message, or maybe I want to show a message in the notification area or someone in the get it started messages, right? Here we can create those, and this is where we can start creating the messages. So if you need to communicate something with your clients, then you can create a message. For example, I am going to do a message team like I have a latest video uploaded here, and I can give this name like check out my YouTube channel. I can put a logo in there, a link to the provide a link for the message. So let's say I'm going to go to https yep, moab.ms or something, the language. I'm gonna put this in. Yes. Oh, I need to have a file in there. Oh, the logo. Crap. I need to have a logo. I don't know. Where's my logo? Oh, maybe in my documents. Let's just find the logo here. I'm not really sure. In YouTube. Let's take this. This is a... Oh, the right dimensions. 60... Oh, okay. This is going to be annoying. Let's skip that. But the thing is, but you can actually see what it would show like, right? And then you can then schedule it, assign it to a group of users, and then at the given time and date, those users will see in their here in their taskbar, they get a pop-up that says, hey, there's a new, something you need to know about. So we can also start sending messages to the users. So these are a couple of things that we, these are a couple of things that we can do in order to make Intune work better for us. So we have added devices and we have a couple of these, let's say basics in Intune that you want to check out here.